All right. Hey there, everyone. Dr. Beth Westie here. Let me just flip the camera real quick so you can see this better. Brighten the image. There we go. Okay. Yes, here we go. Hi, everyone. Happy Thursday. Today I wanted to talk about weight loss for women who are in perimenopause or menopause, some basic places to get started. This is something that a lot of gals struggle with. My hormones change. I'm in a different phase of life. I've had a hysterectomy. I don't know where to start. I don't know what to do. There's so much information out there that it seems very general, right? I don't know what's actually going to be helpful for me. And all the things that I used to do don't work at all anymore. I am working out like crazy. I'm working my butt off. I'm seeing no results in the gym. I've been cutting calories. Nothing's changing. In fact, I think I've gained some more weight after cutting calories. How is that possible? Why? What is happening? You get a different body. You get a different body when your hormones shift and change. It's a different phase of life. And oftentimes that shift and change, it's perceived as like negative. Oh, well, you don't burn calories the same. Okay. But it's not necessarily a bad thing. It's just different. It's just different. So I'm going to talk about a few things that shift and change, some things to really focus on, and then I'm going to give you some amazing tips to get started with. And if you are looking to work with this more, if you're like, I need to dive into this more, I need to get a hormone test to see what my other levels are. I need to see if I have cortisol issues, adrenal fatigue. I think that might be playing a role. Then the 12-week challenge is the place for you. So, 12-week challenge, I actually have an entire, I'm gonna put a link here in the comments for you to get on the wait list. The only way that you can get the registration link is by being on the wait list. So get on this wait list. Do not hesitate. You get your own Dutch test. We go over it. You get customized recommendations, everything else, so that you have the opportunity to work with your system. A lot of the stuff that you're going to learn about your body is really customized, right? It's not, just blanket statements. You get everything tailored and tweaked for you. What are your goals? Where are you stuck? What are your cortisol levels? What are your major stressors in life, right? These are really, really important things where, yes, eating healthy and clean, sure, that can be great. But I mean, honestly, most of the time, women are like, yeah, I'm doing all this stuff. And then is it really just the creamer in my coffee that's throwing things off? No. If you love creamer in your coffee, keep putting creamer in your coffee, and we're going to teach your metabolism to burn everything off. That's what we do. So, where to get started? The first thing, and I talk about protein a lot, but it really is because it's that important. The first thing is increase your protein. When your hormones shift and change, the menopausal body actually needs more protein to do the same thing, to do the same thing that it did before. Why? Why would it need that? It's a hormonal change, right? Your body functions differently. It needs more protein to have the same impact and effect. So if you were eating a certain amount or eating a certain way before going into menopause, eating the same way afterwards means you're protein deficient, which means your body has that much of a harder time building and maintaining lean muscle. And lean muscle is what helps increase your overall metabolism. This is why this is so important. Now, we also talk about gut health things and breaking down that protein and absorbing it really well, because if you eat more protein, you don't want to get any tummy problems, we'll say. But at least 20 grams a day. I do make custom recommendations for each person on this, by the way. If you're like, well, what's right for me? This is what we do in the 12-week program. Get on the wait list in the comments there. But at least 20 more grams a day than what you're eating. This is a great place to start. You will notice a shift and change right away. If nothing else, if no other information you get from this video, get more protein. It's going to change a ton for you. And then when we look at the rest that you get, your brain rest, sleeps different, recovers different, everything changes. So increase rest time in between workouts and everything else, in between sets. Working out faster doesn't burn more. It doesn't give you more of a result with exercise. This is a shift and change in the menopausal body. You need to be more efficient with how you work with your new system. So this is one of the big things to focus on too. Decreasing stress overall. This is sort of a general statement, but once I get to know you better, I can make more specific targeted recommendations on exactly how to decrease stress. Do we need to focus on environmental things? Do we need to focus on toxins? Do we need to focus on getting your brain to wind down better at night? Is it too active and you have a hard time getting to sleep? That's an additional stressor, and stress stores fat. super fun thing about the menopausal body is that stress stores fat really, really well. Like it does a fantastic job of storing fat, like a super extra good job of storing fat. What? Why would it do that? I know, but stress stores fat. We also need to improve your sleep overall. This is going to increase your energy and metabolism. And then also just have hormone help, right? Hormone help, balancing your hormones. This is going to increase your metabolism. This is going to help your system respond better overall. And if you're looking for more resources, I have a book, The Female Menopause Solution. This is all about how to eat for the menopausal body, Female Fat Solution. This has other information on how to eat for your hormones and cycle. These are on Amazon. Great resources and references for you. Other resources I have for you, my podcast, The Female Health Solution. I do talk a lot about how to eat, for the menopausal body and other tips there. And then my YouTube channel is called Dr. Beth Westie. You can subscribe to stay updated on all the videos I have coming out. And if you have other questions on something I covered, do not hesitate to reach out to me. Do not hesitate to ask, how do I do this more? How do I do this better? Or tell me more about the stress thing and my hormones, because I'm really struggling with that. You can leave me a comment. You can message me privately if you're not comfortable commenting. More than happy to give you more information on that. And the last thing I want to mention is my tinctures. These are tinctures for hormones. This is going to help your body produce and maintain the right amount of hormone for you. So it's like seed cycling, but it's a supplement for your body. So I'm very excited. These are about to be released. So let me know if you guys have more questions on that. All right. That's what I got for you guys tonight. Again, menopause weight loss can be one of the most frustrating things because you can put in a ton of effort, energy, and everything and literally feel like you get nowhere with it. This is a place to start. And if you're like, okay, this is good, or I'm learning more about my system here, or this is showing me some positive result, what else can I work on? The 12-week challenge where you get your own Dutch test and we get some customization for you is going to give you the fastest results. That's the benefit of the 12-week. The fastest results for you based on what your body needs. So, all right, that's what I got for you tonight. Have a great rest of your night, and I will see you later.